Leah, why don't you pick things up from here? Talking to Osama about the humanitarian situation, mm-hmm. that includes obviously technology and trying to get the word out, which, well, is it happening?
It is happening. Syria is quite good at actually publishing these videos online. The internet is filled with videos from people inside Ghouta asking for a permanent end to the fighting. That's been their message all along. Here's a journalist reporting from inside the city a few hours after the ceasefire was announced on Tuesday.
Now, as you hear, there is many warplanes on our sky in San Ghouta. Warplanes targeted our besieged San Ghouta. It's 12 o'clock. Russia warplanes targeted anything, as you see.
There are also children reporting from inside eastern Ghouta, and we've been talking to several of them. They're begging for the fighting to stop altogether. Many of them are hiding in shelters underground.
Hello, everybody. 5 hours, ceasefire, but the warplanes in the sky of Ghouta, where is the ceasefire?
We are people of eastern Ghouta in the country of Syria. We live here under bombing and siege. The world has forgotten us. They watching us, they have hunger and bombing. Look at this destruction. This is similar we want to Europe before 8 years ago. What we live today in 21st century, help us and don't be like the rest of the world.
Now, some people think these children are not real, that they're paid to post online and to spread propaganda against the Syrian President Bashar al-Assad. That brings us back to Bana Alabed. You may remember the 8-year-old who was live tweeting during the bombings in Aleppo last year. She was also accused of being fake, though she was not fake. Russian and pro-Assad trolls are once again using the hashtag BanaHoax2 to discredit the children tweeting from within Ghouta. That's including 15-year-old Muhammad, who we just heard from in that video, Elliot Higgins. He's a researcher at King College London. He tweeted a thread on his account proving that Muhammad in particular is in fact real. Higgins said, quote, take this video from February 8th, for example, where Muhammad says his friend's home was bombed. It shows footage of white helmets rescuing people. Then in this screen grab from a white helmet's channel, you can see the rescue operation, which includes one of the same vans filmed by Muhammad. He also compares, he being Elliot Higgins, the researcher, compares different windows and trees and different markings on buildings to prove that Muhammad is in fact where he says he is, comparing those to other videos in the middle of a war zone. Now, many of you have also asked us how you can help these children and others stuck inside Ghouta. The website ghouta.com gives you 10 ways to help people of eastern Ghouta. One of the top ways is to tweet about it with the hashtag Save Ghouta. If you do, be sure to add our hashtag as well, hashtag AJ NewsGrid.